Hey guys, it's Sam with Music at the Marsh, and today I'm with the Holiday Makers.
Hey, what's up, everyone at UHD Radio?
Yeah, they've got an album coming out next week, next year in the summer.
Yeah,
So,
tomorrow.
Yeah, tomorrow. So, like, stay tuned for that. But
Yeah.
Today I'm going to interview them for Music at the Marsh, where we interview, like, local artists, stuff like that. I'm a big fan of the Holiday Makers. I'm like a super fan. I follow
Thank
them
you.
on Twitter.
Yeah. I had this thing. I thought it was really funny in high school when I was like eight, when I was like 16 years old, to come up with band names that were really stupid. And so I've been doing that for a long time. And I wanted to not do that this time around and just kind of be earnest about it or whatever. Not earnest, but I don't know if that's the right word. Just be kind of like cool about it or whatever.
Cool about it.
Yeah. Shout out to Boy Jeans.
Yeah, shut up.
One of my favorite movies is Frank, by directed by Lenny Abraham, Abraham, something like that. And in the soundtrack, one of the songs is called The Holiday Makers, or just Holiday Makers. And I was like, that's awesome. That's a great band name. So I was like, The Holiday Makers.
It's like sentimental.
Yeah, because it's like my favorite movie. It got me through like a bunch. Like, I love Frank the movie. I show it to everyone like that I ever meet. I'm like, hey, we should watch this movie. And it's either this is really good or like they don't care. They DGAF about it.
IGAF. I took a picture with Frank.
Yeah, shout out
I took a
Frank
selfie.
Sidebottom. It was between that or like George Belushi. Or John Belushi and his robotic dog. And I couldn't earnestly like call myself John Belushi and his robotic dog and be a band.
Yeah.
It probably would have worked because I make emo music, so it probably would have been like memorable and people would have listened. But you know, the Holiday Makers, I wanted the and then something.
Not like being serious. I didn't want like a funny jokey joke name.
Yeah. Just because like I didn't want to regret it in the future. Also, I like The Cure. I like saying The Curing. And so The Holiday Making is really funny
The
to me.
Holiday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah. So I think adding ING to the band names is really funny. It doesn't work for some bands like The Smashing Pumpkins.
Yeah, because they're already The Smashing.
Yeah, they're already The Smashing stuff. But like The Curing and like other band names that have the in it.
Like the stroking. Yeah.
The stroking, yeah, dude, I love stroking.
Yeah.
I just think it's really funny. So I was like, I wanna be the Holiday Making. That'd be funny.
That's funny, but, yeah.
Yeah. Also there's it just kinda like sounds nice. It's like a aesthetic, I guess.
Yeah, it's cool. I thought it was cool when you first showed it to me, because it's like,
yeah,
like it makes you think about it like a little bit. Well, not really like deep think, but it's like it's cool.
It's cool. Yeah. I don't like new wave bands names. Like, it's new wave bands are
like what?
Damn, I don't want to call out like people like, but the
I
people
mean,
will have like all lowercase and it'll just be their name. Which I think sucks. Like, people trying to like copy Alex G and stuff and be like their first name and then their last name, but just like the first letter.
Yeah, I get like, I get it. Like, they're trying to be like aesthetic, because you know how like people type in like lowercase. I think they're just trying to go for like a specific thing, but it just looks kind of,
it sucks.
Like,
I think it's
overused.
Awful. I think it works with some stuff, but like not,
it's just
like
really
band
like cliche
names.
Looking like kind of corny almost.
I think bands or like band names at least should be like in your face about the band name. Like, I don't know, it should be like, we're proud of this. I'm
hashtag
a big fan of
Holiday Making Pride.
Yeah, I will be at Pride this year because I'm so proud of my music. I had this like, when I was like 18, I went through like a really like bad breakup, and I didn't like know what to do with my time. So I started like making music because I didn't know what else to do. Yeah. And it was a folk, like queer folk band with my buddy Louie. And we had like a few shows for like house shows, and I played like a few songs and stuff. And it was really fun, but like I had to move to Illinois, so the band kind of ran its course. And once I came back from Illinois, I started making music again, but it wasn't folkish. It was more like emo. It was like reflective of the music I was listening to at the time. So I was listening to like a lot of early emo music, like Modern Baseball and Captain Jazz and stuff like that, like Camping in Alaska. And I noticed like a lot of the music is not, there's like, it's very boyish, like, oh, this town sucks, my girlfriend broke up with me. And so I kind of like wanted to make it more queer-ish, like emo but queer. And there's like already like bands doing that, like Home Is Where and Your Arms Are My Cocoon. And I just wanted to like be in the scene as well. So that's why I kind of like started doing that. Right now, I was just like messing around on the guitar a lot and seeing what kind of sounds good. And then I'll freestyle over the guitar parts. So, and usually whatever I say during that kind of like becomes set in stone. It's very rarely like, do I have pre-written words and then I like write guitar parts to it. It just never works for me. I probably would sound a lot better if I like did it that way. But like, I would just create like a part on the guitar and like talk about whatever is going on in my mind at the time. Because like I have like journals and stuff where I write, and I never like write from it at all. So it's like kind of useless. So I'm just like freestyling. That's why all the songs like kind of talk about the same thing like all the time.
That's okay. Like, your own niche.
Yeah, like, super niche.
That's like the odd man that sings about poop. All the songs are all about poop.
I don't know about that.
Oh, no, like for real. He's like a guy on Spotify.
Yeah.
He's called the odd man that sings all about poop. I tried looking up your name, but he doesn't have a song for your name. So I thought it would have been fun.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Shout out to the poop guy.
Shout out to the poop guy. I want to do a collab. You should do a collab with the poop guy.
Yeah. Do you think he rocks with queer people?
Yeah, he looks like an ally or a member, if I'm being honest.
When I first started making music, it was very like, yeah, it was super folkish, and I was listening to a lot of Jordan Mason and The Microphones and Teen Suicide and like just like really emo stuff. And then once I like stopped listening to that, I moved into more of an emo sound, and I was listening to a lot of Camping in Alaska, Glaucomora, just more like Midwestern emo-ish. I think, yeah, Glaucomora is like something I've been listening to for a while now, and I really, really like into it. And I was like, yeah, I want to make music like that. This is my cat. Sorry. I think a lot of like local probably people, there's a lot of music acts in Dallas and stuff. Not even like Dallas, but like more just like Texas. I think Dead Sullivan's from Texas, and I would love to like do something with them. The scene in Texas is very like huge. There's like local shows going on all the time. So yeah, like Dead Sullivan's one. There's this band that I was really into when I was in high school, called I Hate Sex, and I really, really like their music. So I'd probably do like one of those too. Can I say sex?
Yeah.
I guess more developed and fleshed out. When I first started like learning guitar, I learned it like alone. Like I didn't have any teachers or anything. And everything I've learned on it has just been like because I wanted to do something. So when I started playing when I was like 18, and it was just like cowboy chords, like C and G and D or whatever, and I was like making folk music. And then I got kind of obsessed with like guitar sounding twinkly and stuff, so I learned how to do that. But if you want something to sound kind of like intricate and like pleasant to the ears, you kind of have to like know what you're doing, otherwise it just sounds kind of like bad. And so I hope to just like hope to create something that sounds really good and like something that sounds good and has some sort of meaning, I guess. Whenever I like write music, I don't really try to write meaning behind it. It's like whatever words kind of make sense to like the song. So I mean, I love playing shows. I love like people listening to it. I think the way that emo music is kind of moving forward to is like a more queer and a more personal like sound. I hope to be a part of that and make something that I like and that I enjoy listening to and that other people like and other people enjoy listening to. I guess it's just mainly like putting something out and being like, yeah, I did that. So I think mostly my goals is just to have stuff out there. I don't really necessarily like want to be really famous or anything, but I think a lot of people listen to music in times of like not like crises, but when they're like just looking for like something, and they like find a piece of music that's like really like impactful or whatever. I know like when I was like 17, I found The Glow Part 2, and that was like awesome. And when I was like 17, I found Julia Brown's first album. And when I was like 20, I found a bunch of Glockamora albums. So it was just like maybe being that for somebody else would be really, really sick. It's like music. It's like, yeah, it would be awesome AF. Big shout out to those bands.
Yeah. Shout out to Glockamora.
Yeah, big shout out to them.
Big shout out.
Yeah, I don't even think they exist anymore. Actually, they're like disbanded, but you know,
they're gone.
They're gone. That's they don't cool. exist. But yeah, my main goal is just to like be a part of the queer movement or whatever.
Yeah, I think like what you said, like there's definitely like it's a lot less like white centered. I feel yeah. like obviously there's still like some
people doing issues, that, yeah.
But I think it's less like weird white pedophilic men and more like people who like make actual people. Good music.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, big shout out to everyone who's queer and making music.
Big shout out to people that aren't white pedophilic men.
Yeah. Yeah. That's awesome question. It's cool because when I first started like making music, it was also kind of because I was like making short films in high school, and I was like, I need to make music for this because I can't use copyright stuff. So that's how I got my start. But I think if I were to make music for like a movie, I don't think I would do one that already exists, because like I'm a stickler for like, if it came out this way, then it should be like that way. But if like there was a movie to come out, I think it would be like I don't know if I could make like a soundtrack to a movie. I would prefer it if they took the song that I had already made and just put it in the movie. I think I'd be too scared about the responsibility of being like, hey, here's the movie. Add music to this. I'd be like stressed out.
What like song would you want them to use for like a movie? Or like what movie would you want your songs have been?
I think like coming of age movies are like would probably be best. I think a lot of the music I make is like very early 20-ish type music. Like I can imagine someone in their 50s being like, yo, this shit is hard.
No, so, there's like 50-year-old boy genius fans. You don't know.
I'm not boy genius though. I'm like, I'm the holiday making.
Holiday genius.
Yeah. I couldn't imagine my stuff being in like a movie, like a big budget stuff. I'd imagine it'd be like in a small budget, like short film stuff. I think a lot of the music that I make is very personal, and I'd want it to be in something that's also very personal. I think something like that. Yeah, all the time, I'm like, I make videos or whatever. I also have this small band called Halfway to Hawaii that I'm doing that to. I think I'm still probably doing the folk thing, like the queer folk band. I just got to think about what to do. It's called The Postcards. That's on Bandcamp. As The Postcards 42 Pilots, because I thought that was funny. But yeah. Thanks.
I just thought about that.
It's just like the Holiday Maker is like my main thing. I don't even have like a Bandcamp yet, which is on like YouTube. But I think almost everything that I'm doing is like a side project X. Like there's nothing really like main project-esque. I'm just like chilling at ATM for the most part.
Chilling at ATM.
Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna play you two songs and then I'm gonna like switch guitars after the first song is done because they're in different tunings. The first song is called like, it's a demo, it's a new one. So I hope you like it. Goes like this. Taking off my dresses for you. Can you see your eye? Used to be a boy. Should use your finger to trace your name. On my skin. Should I grip my teeth before I say it? I think I love you.
Awesome as fuck.
Thanks. I'm still a little sick from hashtag slay bomb.
Yeah, hashtag, I didn't know if we could read the chat. Hashtag slay bomb.
I was down with the sickness a few like days ago, and so my voice is like messed up. So like I apologize if it sounds not awesome. Yeah, this song's about two different people that I knew at the same point in my life. One of them I really liked, both of them I really liked, but they both didn't work out. It's called Nothing I Say Will Make This Better. And one of them said that to me, and it stuck with me forever. It goes like this. Gotta tell me when you're going crazy in your room. Cause I don't know the next time I'll see you, and I get scared. Try again. Yeah, that's as good as it can get. Do you have time for one more? Or...
It's up to you.
Oh, I don't remember if I... Shit, I don't know if I remember how to play. I actually don't know if I remember how to play this song. Okay, last one. This one's called Bad Night to Be a Queer. It's about a queer relationship between two people. And, you know, Toni Morrison talks about situationships before they were like situationships. And they were talking about like how you can relate to people, like relationships can be related to like beers. And like the first beer
i.e. the first relationship is the best one because it's your first and you're like thankful for it. Your second one is an extension of the first one. And the third one is just something that you like drink or you do because it's there and you know, why not? And so it's just like, that's how relationships for them were described, like situationships. And this, that's kind of what the song's about. But yeah, it's called Bad Night to Be a Queer. It's like this. Yeah, that's all I have. But yeah, thanks for letting me play for you, man.
Yeah, thanks for playing. This is my first interview.
Yeah, I'm glad to be your first. I hope the rest of them go even better than this one. Yeah. Sorry for being like sick and my voice is like all fucked up and shit. It's like all mangy and
whatever. We could do like, we could always do a follow-up interview.
Yeah, we'll do a follow-up interview once the album comes out. And yeah but yeah, I'm the holiday making, so thanks for everything. Had a wonderful time. Closing time. Every new beginning comes from some other beginning's end. Yeah, cheers, man.
Maybe the real holidays that we're making are all the friends we made along the way.
We're making are on the way. Yeah,
you never put a song like on repeat?
No. Because I hate getting tired of, like, I don't like getting tired of songs.
Yeah, but like if you really really like it, like, you'll never put it on repeat?
Not really. I have one song that I listen to when I'm really like sad. And it's Alex F's Crazy Frog. And on my last FM, you can see that I listened to Crazy Frog like 35 times. So whenever I'm bummed out, I listen to that. I guess we can talk about, because your show's about like local music, we can talk about the scene or whatever.
Yeah, like local, like, yeah, it's just about, yeah, true. I go, like, enough to where I can say, yeah, I go to shows, but, like, I don't really go often.
Yeah. I mean, there's always something going on, like, on the weekend and stuff. Like, people are playing. And,
yeah.
But it's, like, very hit or miss.
Yeah.
I went to a show at Kiki's, which is, a house, like, venue, house. Kind of. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Like, it's just, like, a little house that people play shows at. And I was, like, in the dining room area. And the pit was in the living room area. So I was, like, way in the back because they were, like, hey, the band's playing. Everybody come in. And I was – the person I was, like, with at the time were, like, I was high. And I think they knew I was high, so we kind of, like, stayed back. And
You didn't, like, want to be front and center?
Not really. I mean, some kid got their teeth knocked out and, like, people were passing out and stuff. And, like, I was like, I don't want to do that. And I will high. I'm like a very, like I get high easily and I get freaked out. I get like super freaked out for no reason.
Yeah.
So I didn't want to be around a lot of people. You know that the music video for Everlong by the Foo Fighters?
Oh my God.
It felt like yeah. that party. And I was like, damn, this is just like Everlong. And I was like, I need to get out of here. I know how the video ends. I was like zoned out because this guy next to me was like really into his hat or something. And he was like telling everyone about his hat. And so I was really into That's his me. Hat. Yeah. It was you who was at the show. It was that you. Was I think, me. I think they me. Were Filipino, yeah. actually. If that what? Makes it better.
That kind of makes sense. You know, like the Swagapino movement where they yeah. all had like snapbacks. I have a yeah, snapback was... that says swag. Bimbo on it. Yeah.
Oh, that's hard. That's awesome. Awesome.
Awesome sauce.
Awesome saucing.
Awesome saucing. Why did you type in chat?
I don't know. I got.
Sorry. You see this? Why did you direct message?
Me? I don't know because it doesn't allow anything else. Oh wait,
there's
no,
only two people in here.
Sorry. Yeah. Fuck. Elvis Presley.
Yeah. Fuck all time low.
Fuck all time low and Falling in Reverse. Not because they're weird, movies. Because they suck.
Like Judy Moody goes to college.
I don't know about that, man.
like Scooby Doo goes to college.
More like trying to think of short films right now, but I can't think of anything. I don't know.
Junie B. Jones goes to college.
Yeah, big shout out to Junie B. and Jones.
A favorite book or something.
Yeah, I do actually. It's probably like yeah. When I was in college, my professor gave me this book. It's called The Book of Embraces by Eduardo Galliano. I read this year, and there's like a bunch of notes for like, yeah, I put in like bookmarks for like some of my favorite pieces. It's like a book of poems. There's also money in here because I didn't That's have awesome. Bookmarks in it. But yeah, this is probably my favorite book of all time, maybe. It was really found it. Or I didn't really read it when my professor gave it to me, but I picked it up when I came back home from Illinois. And I guess I read it at the perfect time because it, like, made me open up to the world a little bit more. I was, like, shut off, and this made me be, like, the world is beautiful with that. It's real. And also, like, my buddy, my friend Lyric gave me Nick and Nora's Infinite Playlist because I really like the movie. It has Michael Cera. And I forget her name, but it's a movie. It's not that good of a movie, but it's one of my favorites. It's about like these two people who like the same music, kind of, and they like each other or something like that. This guy's going through a breakup, and this girl knows that he makes mixtapes. He's also in a band. It's a cool movie. But yeah, I try to use this year to read more, but I just couldn't. I spent this year like writing more, if anything.
That's okay. Like,
yeah,
it's always next year.
Always next year, yeah. Or maybe not. It's like kind of late, TBH.
Just 8.
Yeah, I have work tomorrow. I'm a big worker.
Oh, yeah, same. I'm a hard worker.
Yeah, what do you do?
I actually have this radio show every Monday at 10 a.m. Music at the Marsh with UHD Radio.
Yeah, big shout out to UHD Radio.
Yeah, and make sure to follow us on Instagram, TikTok, yeah. and Facebook at UHD iRadio and on Twitter at UHD_iRadio.
Yeah, everyone follow UHD. Thanks for having me on UHD.
Yeah, no problem. Thanks for coming.
Yeah, of course.
Thanks for putting us into your schedule. We could talk about like other stuff, I guess. What's your favorite color?
I'm really into blue right really? Now.
Me too. Like dark blue or like what?
Like pastel.
Pastel blue.
Yeah.
like,
are you looking
yeah,
for
that's Blue's Clues. Yeah, I'm looking at Pastel.
I'm like a big like Green hater.
Oh. Yeah. Me too. I think that color fucking sucks.
I'm really pining to become TikTok famous.
I think you can. I think the way the algorithm is right now is really doesn't make it like easy for people to get famous, but it's like easier than how it used to be.
Yeah. Yeah. I think it's like a double-edged sword though, you know?
Yeah, because you could like easily get exposed to like the wrong crowd.
Yeah. Oh, I was meaning like people being annoying about stuff, I guess. But yeah, that too.
Oh yeah.
I think people, a lot of people blow up. I meant like more of like people blow up some of the worst music you've ever heard in your life. Most people at the shows are like just like staring at me intensely. And I think if I looked up and I saw someone holding up like a picture or something, I'd laugh really loud.
Yeah.
And then, like, I'd get thrown off. So
yeah.
I think, yeah, if people were making fan cams of me, I'd or like photoshopping me into stuff, it'd be awesome.
I would hate that. I would hate that so much. Like, just the thought of, like, someone editing, like, my picture to be, like, in front of the White House.
Yeah, I've only had, like, two pieces of fan art made. But I know those are really cool, so.
Shout out.
Shout out fan arting.
Shout out fan arting.
Yeah, farting.
I think the constant. I thought Running Red came to jail.
Yeah, fuck Panic at the Disco.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I think I hate so Brendan Urie.
I hate that guy. He's like the Matty Healy of like, you know what? Yeah. He is like Matty Healy because they both did songs with Taylor Swift. No, Matty Healy didn't do a song with Taylor Swift. He did another thing. He did things with Taylor Swift. He did other things.
Yeah.
But, like, they're weird.
Yeah, fuck Taylor Swift. Fuck Justin Bieber.
There used to be a problem where people thought Paramore was just Haley. And she's like, no, Paramore's everyone around the world.
That's so awesome. No, Holiday Makers is just me. I put all my blood, sweat, and tears. You guys cannot be a part of the band.
This
sorry.
Is my bad. Who do you think your celebrity like lookalike is? Like, if anyone was like, dang,
Drake.
Are you...